Winfield 1873C is a versatile lever-action rifle that'll be most useful at close ranges. Boasting a high rate of fire at a very cheap price, it does a fine job. Being unlocked at level 1, many new players end up using this gun. This either makes or breaks their first hunt experience, because if you can't land shots, you're gonna have an awful time. Being loaded with compact ammo, you'll have more than enough bullets at your disposal, unless of course you shoot everything in sight. Doing 110 damage, you can expect this weapon to two-tap hunters at close range, but it becomes a bit of a pea shooter at far distances, sometimes taking 3 or even 4 shots to seal the deal. That being said, if you're a sweaty no-life crack shot that can pop melons, you have 151 meters of range to ruin someone's day. With a fire rate of 29 rounds per minute and a cycle time of a little over a second, you can pump out a lot of bullets in a short amount of time. The hipfire spread is pretty decent, so hitting whatever's in your crosshairs can be common. The lack of sway when you're aiming is even better, and you'll find there's barely any recoil when you shoot. All in all, you can expect your sights to stay put when firing multiple rounds. Your reload speed from empty will take about 10 seconds. But if you're fine without that final bullet, you'll save even more time. With a muzzle velocity of 400 meters per second, you won't have to lead your shots as much at all. There doesn't seem to be any damage reduction when firing through a single wooden wall, but after passing through 2, you'll see the numbers drop a bit. So, if you have wall hacks, keep this in mind. For its price, the stats of this gun are pretty desirable. I think it's time to take it for a spin. I brought it into a solo game to fight the butcher with it. I gotta say, it did a piss poor job at damaging him. This is pretty standard for low tier rifles though, so I'm not gonna dock points. Just something to be aware of. After extracting, I picked up a trait called levering. For those of you that are new, levering basically turns you into a professional gunslinger when hip-firing lever-action weapons. Your fire rate when hip-firing skyrockets, making you a real menace up close. The recoil and spread RNG can be hard to manage, but the sheer amount of bullets you let fly out can be enough to win a firefight. There's also a neat combo you can pull off, where you fire while ADS and then quickly swap to hip-fire to shoot another round faster than you normally could. This may not be extremely useful, but it's something you can do. I loaded into another solo game and fought the butcher once again. As you can see, levering helps a lot when killing bosses. After banishing, I sought out the other teams for some PvP gameplay, and boy did I get creamed. I just couldn't land any follow-up shots, and therefore had an awful time. I also forgot I had levering, and didn't even try to use it on him. My next few matches weren't any better. After many deaths, I finally got a kill. My cracked MLG skills wore off immediately, but whatever. I got my kill and was ready to move on to the next variant. Okay, so the silence variant of the Windfield is essentially the same weapon, but silent. I mean, go figure. However, the muzzle velocity takes a hit, going from 400 meters per second all the way down to 250. You'll have to lead your shots a lot more than normal. That's why I would recommend bringing the high velocity ammo along with it. It more than makes up for what you lose, bringing it up to 450. The sights on the weapon also change as well. Instead of the normal clean iron sights, you get this dog shit junk on top. It makes it hard to see what you're aiming at, probably done as a balancing act. On top of those two huge nerfs, you also get some less noticeable ones. Your headshot range decreases to 135 meters, meaning your damage fall off happens even sooner. Also, the spread and sway becomes slightly worse. Is all that worth becoming a silent killer? If you're a cringe cane sitting in a bush a million miles away, you'd probably say yes. I loaded into another solo game and ran into a couple teams fighting the assassin. Flanked around a building and managed to pick a guy off. His teammate came running to rescue him, but she was no match for the gangster. Not sure what the plan was there. After looting, I went inside to finish killing the boss. Look, not every ending is happy, alright? Next variant. Throwing a marksman scope on a Windfield seemed cursed at first, but it actually grew on me. It's nearly identical in stats to the normal weapon, but now you can see a lot farther, and the sway is improved, making headshots easier. If you bring along the trait Marksman Scopesmith, that sway becomes even better, though I never found it necessary. You might want to consider popping in some FMJ ammo though, because that'll bring that headshot range up to 194 meters, with a small sacrifice to your velocity. Obviously, it's harder to use in a close range battle, seeing as how the spread takes a significant drop, but with the right secondary weapon you'll have a good loadout. Taking it into the bayou, I posted up in a silo outside of the boss lair. One team was fighting Scrapbeak, and another was trying to jump in. I strongly considered popping somebody's head, but decided against it. Instead, I waited an embarrassing amount of time for a fight to happen. Once bullets started flying, I hopped out of the silo to get in on the action. I snuck in like a leopard, getting behind an unsuspecting team. I pounced. This game. The Windfield has a cheaper two-slot variant that only costs $3,500. It takes a hit in just about every department compared to its big brother. Most notably, you'll find the spread, sway, and recoil to be almost twice as bad. I would avoid using levering on this thing. Its bullet capacity also shrinks by a single bullet, which would probably go unnoticed if I didn't mention it. It still works pretty well in close range engagements, but I wouldn't even try using it at far range. Brought incendiary ammo along with the Vandal, just to spice things up a bit. All it really does is set things on fire, which will one-shot most AI and instantly bring enemy hunters into a panic as their life slowly melts away. Oh. And it also explodes red barrels too, which I was gonna do here until I was brutally interrupted. Anyways, I got my kill with a Vandal. Push up to kill some people. Then die to the same bitch I just murdered. Could I have been more cautious? Yeah. Did I care? Not at all. Vandal has a variant that includes a saw blade and knife at the tip of the gun, used for hacking and stabbing. It's god awful! The damage numbers with them are terrible, so if you're expecting to melee rush a full health hunter and win, you better be aiming for their face. Even then, the reach this thing has is piss poor. Seriously, think back and try to remember a time you died to a Vandal Striker. What's that? You can't? Neither can anyone else. Looking past how bad the melee is, I guess there really is no downside to bringing this over to the normal Vandal. The stats are nearly identical outside of the melee. The only stat that is affected is the cycle time by 0.1 second, and the price is increased by only $4. Why Crytek decided such a small change was necessary, we'll never know. I brought it into a game and brought along a Winfield Marksman, just to round out my loadout a bit. I rolled up to Fort Biden and fought a duo. They were easy pickings. Excellent. While fighting the assassin, I heard some movement in a nearby building. Went outside to investigate. Sheriff Harden peeked me, and I reacted quickly, but not quick enough. I heard the satisfying splat of a headshot, but for whatever reason, I did phantom damage. I got up, he shot me, and I escaped. Resilience Necro for the win. I fought him again, and he bested me. Again. I decided that I wanted my bars back before it was too late, so I quickly killed the assassin using my incendiary ammo to speed up the process. Then, my final fight with Mr. Harden began. I shot him from afar and he ran. Listen to Spoob's beautiful voice.
Hearing voices telling me that I should get some sleep, because tomorrow might be good or something. Feeling like I'm heading for a breakdown, and I don't know why.
Just like that, it was over. Have you ever thought to yourself, man, I wish I had a scope on the Winfield M1873C Vandal. And boy, do I have good news for you. This gun allows you to pick fights at further distance, although the scope isn't as magnified as a marksman. This could be a good thing, however, since close range battles will still be manageable. Similar to the marksman weapons, guns, with the Deadeye Scope benefit from Deadeye Scope's myth. Pick this up if you want less weapon sway. As for stats, there's actually only one change when compared to the normal Vandal, and that's the spread. It has been increased to 50. Well, you shouldn't be hep firing with a Vandal anyway, so big whoop. As for ammo, once again I'd bring FMJ rounds. It's just going to give you more range to play with. In my final game, I found myself at 4 Biden once again. This time with Scrapbeak. I popped shots at a hunter and missed every time. Another solo player had arrived for some fun, and they became distracted by each other. Typical hunt fashion, they traded. They both self-rezzed and fought again. This time with an actual winner. I took care of that winner. Again. And again.
Dude, you should probably just leave, honestly.
Why should I leave?
Not you guys.
Nearby, I heard footsteps, so I positioned myself outside the boss lair, waiting for someone to run in my sights. Missed and narrowly escaped with my life. There's more than one team here, so it's gonna be fun. See, levering's awesome when the RNG god is smiling down on you. Powerful, I charge out there and quick scope a guy in the face.
Come on, dude, I'm too good right now. Hey, you solo? You want to extract together? You don't have to fight.
Felt other ways, I guess.
After waiting a minute, I got up and chased that fucker down. I was not gonna let this. Extracted with a total of 8 kills that match. It's tier time, which means the weapons I use today are going to be judged on 4 criteria, based solely on my experience as a mid-hunt player. First off is its value, how well the weapon performs in comparison to its price. Second is the ability to kill, how often was I able to kill an enemy hunter with this weapon. 3 is its utilization. How useful is weapon outside of PvP combat? And 4 is badassery. How badass do you look using this weapon? That's what I like to call the VAUB system, and it perfectly determines weapon's worth. If you don't like what the system has to say, then cry about it. Getting started, we have the base Winfield M1873C. Guys, you might hate me for this, but I gotta put in the C tier. I'm just not a Winfield enjoyer. Never was. I know it's a skill issue, but still, it's hard for me to rate this weapon any higher, when it has better variants that open up new doors of opportunity. Windfield Silencer opens the door of stealth. That's huge in this game. Even with the terrible sights, you can still pick people off, because they'll struggle to know where you are, giving you time to line up your shots. Certified Kane Classic, B tier. The Marksman, to me, is also B tier. Not great by any means. There are certainly better snipers to choose from, but this thing makes it so much easier to pop heads at a distance. Play range, bring a good secondary, and you'll have fun with this. Winfield Vandal is almost D tier, but I decided to put it in C, because of two things. First, the fact that it takes up one less weapon slot. Second, it's cheap. The Vandal Striker is actually just the same gun as the Vandal, and I refuse to put it up higher because it has melee tools. C tier. The Vandal Deadeye is definitely the most useful of the Vandals. Again, because of the head pop ability. It's really the only one I'll ever consider using in normal gameplay, therefore it's a B tier. All these Winfields are cheap options, and you certainly get what you pay for. They all work with levering, which makes you look badass. Without it, they're kind of boring. None of them are great, none of them are bad. The Valve system hereby states that the Winfield 1873C is... mid. Well, that just about wraps things up. If you enjoyed this type of video, and you're interested in more weapon reviews, please leave a like, a comment, and consider subscribing. My current plan is to go through all the weapons in Bloodline unlock order, but if there's a weapon you want to see reviewed, just let me know and I might change it up. Thanks for watching, and keep it poppin'.